Hi guys, it's Raphael here from Roaming the Moon, and we are here with Alex Michel, who will be giving a few tips for those who are moving abroad and speak two or three languages on how to get a job in another country. So you have a lot of experience helping people with translation.
Yes.
And so if people move abroad and they speak two or three languages, mm-hmm. how easy it is to get a job as a translator?
It's not as easy as it used to be. A lot of companies now will expect you to have at least 4 years experience and then maybe a further 2 years on top of that with a specialism. One of the things that most companies will want now is that a linguist degree. You can sometimes find work without going to an LSP. So maybe going direct to the company and being able to prove that you are actually good at translation to be able to circumnavigate that system. But generally speaking, you would need to have some kind of experience before a company would let you do it.
Okay. And what is the easiest or the top language at the moment that people can find a job? You know, what is, apart from English,
yeah.
you know, what is the second language most required?
Top languages are the fixed languages. So you've got French, Italian, German and Spanish. But we're also finding a big increase in Arabic and also with Brazilian Portuguese because of the World Cup and the Olympics coming up. So they're the kind of merging markets, as well as China, obviously. I guess the one difficulty with China is the cost of translation within China is very cheap, so it's quite hard for English or UK companies to be competitive.
I see. And now let's think about those who don't speak another language. So if they're moving because they want to learn the language, mm-hmm. but they are in situations where they will need a translator or they will need someone to help them.
I think a really good service for these kind of people, because the main thing will be to keep costs low. They wouldn't be able to afford, say, £150 to have somebody with them for a couple of hours. So what you could do if they were having difficulties with a language barrier is there's a telephone interpreting service where they would just simply ring up a telephone number, put in the code for the language that they want help with, and then there'll be an interpreter at the other end of the phone, and they're just charged the minute rate. And then at the end of the month, however many minutes they use, they're then billed for. And that's a much more cost-effective way for helping people within a new country.
Oh, it sounds like having a friend that speaks the language in
exactly.
another country.
Exactly, it's like having a guidebook, but better.
Okay, well, that's great.
Okay.
So if you are feeling lost in translation and you need a little bit of help, check the website that is showing now on the bottom of the screen and have a great trip.